الحمد لله. We thank Allah سبحانه وتعالى. We praise Him that we are Muslimin. We praise Him that we are part of the Ummah of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. Sadly, we are facing great difficulties and challenges at the moment where Muslims are calling other Muslims names. Muslims are not helping other Muslims. Instead, they are busy fighting one another. We ask Allah سبحانه وتعالى to protect us. If we take a look at the Quran, it describes the mu'mineen and the believers as brothers. Allah says,
إنما المؤمنون إخوة فأصلحوا بين أخويكم واتقوا الله لعلكم ترحمون.
Indeed, the believers are brothers. So if we would like to understand that from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the correct way, we should be resolving matters that arise between us in a way that results in the togetherness of the ummah and in bringing together those who are perhaps fighting. Rather, what is happening today is we are splitting the ummah even further, and we happen to find the smallest reason to call someone a bad name, whereas we were taught to find the smallest reason to call someone a good name. We were taught to find the smallest reason to bring people together. But today, sadly, and we all know this, people are looking for the slightest difference. It is very sad. We are supposed to be a united ummah. Sadly, what is happening is difference of opinion. We perhaps do not know how to handle it. We do not realize that there will always be difference of opinion. But how we handle it is what will make us part of the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Remember, when we learn the deen, which is a duty upon us, when we learn the religion, when we learn what the revelation stands for and what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed to us, we will definitely be able to pick up that there are people who are out there preaching goodness. They would like to see goodness. They would like to see people unite. They would like to see peace and stability, security. They would like to see goodness for everyone. And on the other hand, it does not take a rocket scientist to discover that there are some out there who only know how to call names, who only know how to harm others, who perhaps are doing very good work just because of a difference or two. We also see others who perhaps would like to call people such derogatory terms that it instills hatred in the hearts of the people against otherwise decent people. Let us be warned. Let us be careful of this type of behavior. Let us not support such activity. Let us make sure that we follow the true deen, the deen that our forefathers have brought down with goodness. Yes, we do know that if our forefathers have erred and if they have done something that is contrary to revelation, we will indeed rectify that. We do not just blindly follow. But at the same time, we do know that it is our duty to be able to bring people together, to try our best to bring people together, not to support those who are causing mischief, not to support those who have nothing better to say, but to hurt others, to harm others, to say bad words about others. This is indeed a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are now living at a time where technology is progressing very rapidly. Let us use that technology to bring people together rather than to drift people away. Let us use that technology to spread peace and love, harmony and goodness, justice and equality, rather than taking people away from the good values of the deen of Islam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us. I really call upon all the scholars out there to promote goodness and tolerance, to promote inter-scholarly tolerance, that which would be among the scholars a good move, inshallah. And what would happen is the public would immediately understand that if the scholars have an understanding, even with their differences of opinion, then perhaps it's about time we tolerated one another. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to help one another. Jazakumullahu khairan.